Welcome to the County Ground in Bristol. I'm Ian Harvey, and I'm at my old club, Gloucestershire, for another packed edition of the LV County Catch-Up. I had a great time here as a player, winning 6 one-day trophies, included a spell of 5 in 2 years. This year, Gloucestershire are sadly going to miss out on any titles, but there's no doubt the seeds are being sown for future triumphs. So today, I'm going to go behind the scenes to meet some of the young talent currently in the squad, and to introduce you to some of the personalities at the club. I'll be chatting to all-rounder and Kiwi superstar, Hamish Marshall. Once again, those fierce rivals, batsman and bowler, go head-to-head in bat v ball. And the Gloucestershire boys go for glory in the legendary Sticky Wicket Challenge. So what do we know about the County Ground? Well, it dates back to the 19th century. And the team that included the great W.G. Grace moved in here. William Gilbert Grace must be the most iconic figure in the club's history, a founding father of cricket, not just here, but vital in its development across the planet. A true revolutionary within the game and an outstanding player. There are tributes, references, and reminders of him dotted all over the ground. Have a look who it is, the great man himself, W.G. Over 50,000 first-class runs, can you believe that? He's not very talkative, he's a bit shy, so we're not going to get a lot out of him, but he's just popped down to the ground to give a few of the boys a few tips. Welcome home, son. Welcome home. Everywhere you look around this County Ground, there's memories, legends of the game, Alex Gibman, Martin Ball, and in the past, they've even had some good-looking chaps here. Right, one of the new additions to what we've been talking about, a new pavilion, change rooms, completely different from where we were. When I was playing, we were downstairs underneath, and you come in. The space that the players need with all their gear. And one of the things I'm glad that we didn't have when I was playing is these two Matthew ice baths we've got in here. Cricket bats, cricket gear, and pretty much a must for most cricketers. Good old golf club floating around the changing rooms. You never see too many cricketers without those. Most pavilions, most changing rooms have their own honours board. It looks like the Gloucester boys, 2014, they've started putting their little honours board up here. It's a great little memento for all the boys to show what they have done throughout the season. So we've just lost a wicket, and this is the walk we have to take. Past your teammates, then you've got to walk past the 12th man, opposition coach, so it's a little bit nerve-wracking. All the emotions going through in your mind about what's happening out in the middle. And then this is it, down the steps we go, out into the middle, and hopefully make some runs. So now it's time to catch up with a man who's become over the last decade the heartbeat of this Gloucestershire team. New Zealand international, it's got down here all-rounder. I'm not sure about the all-rounder bit, but Hamish Marshall, good to see you, buddy.
How are you, Habs?
Now, why this club and what's so special about Gloucestershire County Cricket?
Well, 2006 was my first season, and I was welcomed, you know, when I first got here, the changing room, the supporters, everyone were extremely friendly. And at the time, you know, the club had come off a pretty successful period, so everything was quite a buzz here. And I just really enjoyed my time here. Bristol's a great city, you know, I really enjoy the city here. It's busy without being too busy. And you get close to things just outside of Bristol. It takes you 15 minutes to get to, and you're out in the wilderness sort of.
He really had to make a really tough decision to move to the UK. Gave up a promising test career. How difficult of a decision was that for you?
At the time, quite difficult actually. You know, I was enjoying the environment of playing in New Zealand with the New Zealand team. I was a little bit in and out at the time, which probably swayed my decision. I didn't see, you know, I saw myself struggling a little bit to be in there permanently, and I wanted to play cricket all year round and consistently, and county cricket offered me that. You know, you play a lot of cricket here, it's a great standard, you know, supported really well, and I just thought the professional environment here was something I enjoyed.
We all sit down at the start of a season as a club, and we all say we want promotion and we want to win trophies. Next season, do you think promotion for Gloucester is achievable?
I think it's achievable. You know, it'll be tough. We're going to have to perform very well. But as I said, the way our four-day cricket is about taking 20 wickets, and our bowling group are making good strides. And next year, you know, hopefully we've grown again, and they'll have learnt more, and we can take those 20 wickets more consistently. And if so, you know, then we win games. Of course, the batting group. You know, last year we had a phenomenal year and got a lot of runs. This year, not so much. But we need to put some runs on the board so they can bowl at that. But you know, if we can do that, then you know that bowling group, you know, there's a lot of talent there, and we just need to try and keep guys fit.
So it's been a bit of an up and down season, mate. But you got some good young talent at the club. Have you got anyone there that you think that may be able to go to that next level and maybe pull on the England jersey?
Craig Miles, for me, is the really exciting one. He's a young fast bowler. Got all the attributes. He's tall, he's athletic, he's a bit like sort of Stuart Broad sort of build. Bowls a heavy ball, can swing it in the air, which I think is important at test level. And yeah, he's very promising and a great attitude towards the game.
Now finally, next year, big season for you next year, benefit year. Yeah. Have you got any big events planned for next season?
The committee are on, got a few ideas. you know, there's some dinners hopefully arranged. I know it's a big year sporting-wise in the UK with the Ashes and the World Cup rugby and New Zealand cricket tour. So there's some ideas being thrown around. We'll have a few golf days for you, Harv.
Yeah, I'll be free for those.
And no, there'll be some events in the county that hopefully the members and supporters can enjoy and get involved in.
Mate. Thanks very much.
Always a pleasure.
An absolute
Harv.
Pleasure. All the best for the rest of the season.
Thanks,
and
mate.
Good luck for the benefit season next year.
Champion. Cheers, mate.
Well, now two of Gloucestershire's promising young players go head-to-head in bat v ball.
Hi, I'm Benny Howe. I am representing the batters, and this is my buzzer.
Hi, my name's Jack Taylor. I'm representing the bowlers, and here's my buzzer.
Right, as you can see, we've got two of the coolest blokes here in Bristol with their glasses on. Now, boys, the rules are simple. If you know the answer, buzz away. If you buzz in too early, you'll forfeit your go and it'll go to your opposition. So, but the one thing, you have to wait until I've finished the question. Right, question one. Which Gloucestershire wicketkeeper shares the same name as a dog breed? You're still thinking about it, aren't you?
No, I've got it.
Right, well, it's a bit late now.
Jack Russell.
Very good, Jack. Very good.
You got the one? Yeah, I did that.
Right, question two. Which batsman passed the 10,000 first-class runs mark for Gloucester this season? I'm going with Benny on that.
Marshall.
That is incorrect.
Alex Gibbon.
Very good.
I was going to do one.
Very good. Right, question three. Who was the first player to ever score a 2020-100? I'm going with you again on this, Benny.
O'Brien.
I can't believe you've just said that. I cannot believe you have just said that.
Is this for Gloucestershire? It's on.
I can't believe that. No! What is going on here? Have we got two other blokes who want to come and have a go or not?
Who was it?
You both got it. It was me.
Yeah, I have, yeah.
Didn't know that.
Well, it's a bit late now, isn't it? Question four. Who hit a record 10th wicket stand of 137 for Gloucestershire earlier this season?
No, it's too early.
Far too early. Far too early.
Craig Miles and Lynn Norwell.
Very good. Yeah. Very good. You're off and running.
Yes, come on.
You're off and running. What is a Gloucestershire old spot?
Hat.
What?
That'd be no.
I don't know. You don't.
Clue. Is that old spot?
You giving up on that
yeah,
one?
No.
It's a type of pig.
Okay.
Right. So you learn something new every day, don't you? Right, question six. What subjects does your teammate, Will Taveray, have a degree in? Physics?
Too early.
Chemistry or biology?
I know this one.
Biology.
Did you push your buzzer?
No, he didn't.
No, he passed it on.
He didn't push
it. Right, yeah, I'll let you off on that one. What is it?
Biology.
Right, very good.
Is it right?
Do you understand? Do you want me to go through the rules again?
Yeah, I thought you were going to finish. There was a bit of a pause.
You see, you're so premature, you panic. Stop panicking.
He's W.G. Grace, the legendary Gloucestershire and England cricketer, scored more than 50,000 first-class runs.
He has a bit.
But what does the W stand for?
William.
Very good, Jack. Very good. Very good. Question eight. Guess. How many one-day trophies did Gloucestershire win between 99 and 2000? Benny.
Two.
No.
Three.
No. Both wrong.
Four.
No.
Five.
One.
Five.
Oh, in 2 years.
Yeah. We were quite good back then.
Well, we don't have that many trophies now, do we?
Right. Thank God this is the final question. Which former Gloucestershire fast bowler is the record wicket taker for the West Indies?
Courtney Walsh.
Very good, Jack. Very good. Righto, boys, well done. That's the end of the quiz. And I can now reveal, Jack, you won that 4-2. Benny, very unlucky, mate.
It was unlucky.
Unlucky, mate. Yeah, good effort. Cheers. It wasn't much of a challenge.
Well, so far in the series, the batsmen have had the edge. But the bowlers get their revenge today with a hard-earned victory. Now the tables are turned as I answer the questions in Over and Out. Just the way that they played, the likes of Viv Richards and Ian Botham, they went out there and they were very attacking, and it was just someone where I just loved to sit back and just watch play cricket, because they, for me, that's what it's all about, the entertainment side of things. And so for me on that one, Ian Botham and Viv Richards. It's quite a tough one, that one, because I was lucky enough that I did play with a few decent players, but for me, Shane Warne, absolutely unbelievable. I mean, his career, and everyone's seen the way he plays, the way he bowls. Again, with the bat, he was fantastic. And just for me, every time he got the ball in the hand, you just thought something's going to happen here, and everyone was glued to their screens. Well, there's been a few of those as well, which is quite a tough one. But for me, the one that I really struggled with, who I thought was an absolute fantastic bowler, was Wasi Makram. I don't think it comes much better than that. With the new ball, the old ball, he was outstanding. The 2003 World Cup, 2 weeks before, wasn't even selected in the squad, and unlucky for Shane Watson, but luckily enough for me, he ended up with stress fractures at the back, and I got the phone call to go over and to be a part of the team going through the World Cup undefeated, and then in the final, Ricky Ponting, an unbelievable 100. It was just unbelievable to be just part of that whole experience. The mental side of things, I think we see a lot of talented players, but when they get into the Test arena, it does become quite tough for them. And it is, for me, more mental than the ability. I've been playing a little bit of club cricket this year, and one of the teams we play against is Taunton, and they've got a young kid there, Tom Abel. I think he is a player to really look out for in the future. He just played his first class game for Somerset, got 95 in his first inning. So I think for me, not many people will know that name, but I can guarantee you in a few years' time they will. Now, you might think the LV County Championship is quite competitive, but wait until you see this. It's time for the legendary Sticky Wicket. This is a timed obstacle relay race. The rules are simple. Three players each take a turn to go up and down the course, all the time juggling a ball on a bat. There's a 5-second penalty if they drop the ball and a 10-second penalty for any shortcuts.
My name's Ian Cobain, aka The Bird's Nest.
I'm David Payne, aka Flash Payne.
And I'm William Tevere, better known as Postman Pat, and we're Team Gloucestershire.
Three, two, one, go.
Killing it!
There we go.
Go on, Flash. Come on, Dave.
Well, last time out, Notch smashed the course record with a time of 32.3 seconds. But our boys completed it in 34.9, which puts them in second place. Well, that's all from Bristol today. Don't forget you can follow us on Facebook and Twitter to get closer to the action and all your favourite cricketers, and to get the heads up on what's next on the LV County Catch-Up. It's been a real pleasure being back at my old ground. I hope you've enjoyed it too. Next time, you can catch us at the home of the new LV County Champions. See you.